Hey everybody, it's Chainsaw Reacts back once again, another reaction for you guys. Today, guys, of course, I'm here continuing the journey of Ben 10 Alien Force. I'm loving the show so far, as you guys know. I cannot wait to continue each week, and thank you guys so much for supporting the videos. This is Season 1, Episode 9 of the show. Once again, not seeing the title until after the episode in case of spoilers. Now, my Discord has been a little bit mixed on me watching this episode because they're curious to see how I'm going to respond to it, which honestly has made me a little nervous. I'm kind of worried, but at the same time, I'm loving the hell out of this show. It's kicking ass, and I love the fact that it's darker. I love the fact that they're doing things in this show that they couldn't have done in Ben 10, because tonally, I don't think it would have worked as well. And the fact is, too, they didn't waste any time establishing the darker elements of Alien Force within Alien Force. Obviously, there are a lot of things that are similar in terms of Ben 10 and Alien Force, but there are some changes, some differences, besides the fact that the Omnitrix recalibrated or whatever the hell it did, and we have new aliens and everything. But the fact is now is that Ben and Gwen are in a different place now, and of course Kevin's in the mix, so there's a lot of things that are familiar and different, and I love that about Alien Force. So last episode that I watched was actually earlier today. Be Knighted was kind of a crazy ride because I wasn't sure where it was going. The Forever Knights were back, and then there's this dragon, turns out to be an alien, that was captured for 1,000 years. It's still baffling. Wasn't there to attack them, but they captured the alien dragon because they thought it was a monster. He was there to map out the planet or map out the stars or whatever the hell he was doing. He was a map maker. He wasn't there to attack anybody. He wanted revenge, and I've already made my points in the video saying I wouldn't have blamed him if he would have got revenge. I think he deserves some revenge, in my personal opinion. Who knows? He may be back. I don't know. Don't think so, but if he shows up with some more of his friends and they decide to get the revenge on the Forever Knights, I'll be sitting front row seat with popcorn. That's just my two cents. But I love the fact that the show's darker. I love the fact that we're seeing more of Ben and Gwen and Kevin's development in terms of working together as a team. Kevin's still being Kevin, but at least they're finding a way, a dynamic to work together. So, yeah, let's get into the episode. Let's stop talking. Let's see what happens here because, like I said, my Discord, they're curious to see how I'm going to respond to this. So, let's dive in. Let's see what happens here. Episode 9 of Ben 10, Alien Force.
My dear Kevin, your next editorial bellicosity.
Cannonball!
He should have turned into cannonballs if he could. Oh.
Involuntary cognitive discharge. My intense electromagnetic storm is gilding the lily. I submit
that I wasn't even thinking hard.
What's going on, Gwen? Oh, Max, okay.
He wanted me to release it, but I put up a big fuss. It was my fish, you know?
For a secret place, this gets a lot of traffic.
Did you ever see a flower like that, Ben?
That woman just disappeared.
Yeah, she
Teleporter,
did.
Teleporter, maybe?
That was weird.
What was she doing? I should be able to track her with this.
Oh.
I really thought I had that moved down.
This is crazy. She didn't show yesterday, and she's
oh, they've been waiting for how long?
Tonight.
Humor me.
Don't do that.
I'll drive you.
No. Keep watch. I'll be right back.
Okay, you're gonna walk a couple miles?
Exactly. Look.
Oh, is she back?
How do you know Max Tennyson?
I figured that was Max on the thing, but who's Verdona? Whoa.
Go away.
Wait a minute. What? Jet Ray. Jet Ray. Catching up. Yep. That was cool. Aha.
Answers, lady. We're done playing.
It's the same magic. Oh my god. What? What? What?
This little world would be a lot more tolerable without troublemaking imps like you.
Can't I leave you guys alone for 2 minutes?
Exactly.
Do that again.
Just who do you think you are, littering my grandpa's cove with your flowers?
Flowers that she makes out of energy.
Did you say Max was your grandfather?
Yes.
Kiddo!
Kiddo?
He was my grandpa, too.
I'm Verdona.
Hi.
We'll talk again soon.
I think we just met our grandmother.
Dad, we need to...
Dad? What?
In your room?
Quit.
I've been keeping a big secret from you.
Okay.
Come on, Gwen. There's no such thing.
But...
Is that George Newbern?
There's more.
Superman?
I met Grandma Verdona today.
I was afraid this day might come.
What?
But what? But she showed any signs of having powers. Your grandma's an alien.
What? What?
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
Levin?
Let's ask her. Your friends aren't the only ones who sneak around eavesdropping on people. Isn't that right, Mom?
Oh, shit.
Verdona, what a surprise.
This is a lot. This is a lot, guys. Oh, my God. Oh, Mom.
Your grandmother is an Anodyte, and so are you.
What's an Anodyte?
Anodyte.
Anodytes are a race of free spirits. I fell deeply in love with Max Tennyson and ditched him.
Oh.
And Max was busy saving the universe.
Oh, I love that. Why can't we have a show like that?
What's mana?
Your grandpa's fate was big news. Let me teach you to master life energy. That's
okay.
What mana is. Stop living this humdrum life.
I'm gonna choose. Oh.
Join the real party.
This is too huge.
Yeah, can't make a decision now.
Dad?
We won't stand in your way, Gwen.
She's gonna choose to stay here, right? Right?
Such a serious girl.
Well, yeah, this is a big decision.
Grandma could teach you to do all that stuff she can do.
But she would have to leave Earth.
Gone for a long time, I guess.
Yeah.
Maybe forever. We'll miss you if you go.
Really?
She's not gonna go. I don't think.
But we've been recruiting more and more plumber kids, so maybe you owe it to yourself to try turning into a cosmic mana master.
Sure. That'd be cool.
It's a once in a lifetime opportunity. I want you around. The whole thing's lame.
Let's be honest. Oh! Oh, okay.
Lame!
You taught me a lot, Mom. You and Dad both.
You know what I mean. I even came back when the grandkids were born.
I want to stay here with my friends.
Are you going to be okay with that? Uh-oh.
We belong on Anodyne among our kind.
Well, I mean, she's choosing not to go. Whoa.
See? Just a disguise. This is what it means.
Oh, my God. Okay.
You're just too young to make up your own mind.
Is he going to force her?
Let me help you. How do you know whether you like something if you don't try it?
That's a good point, but don't destroy the body.
Another dance boy?
So Grandma's kind of crazy. Yeah. Oh,
this is what I call a party.
Gwen, stay back.
Think smart.
Hit the road, Kevin.
Huh?
Ooh. There you go.
Spider monkey!
Spider monkey! Holy crap! Damn, kicking her. There you go. I don't know. I don't know about that. Oh, crap.
I don't know if I can pound your grandma.
Absorbing the mana or whatever, the energy.
I'm really enjoying this.
But why are you... I don't know why you're doing this.
I should get out more often.
No, because you're not a very nice person, it seems. Oh. My God.
One day you'll learn to make a new body.
I am not going. I love having powers, but I like my life better. All those good times you had with Grandpa?
Oh, I was just a kid. Max should have been like us. He had a spark all his own.
You're an energy being. I'm a girl.
Maybe I've forgotten what that's like.
I'm not going with you, Grandma.
No, I don't believe you are. Goodbye, all.
Goodbye. That was
crazy.
Wait
to stick up for your cousin. Grandma's going to drop in now and again to see how you're doing.
Okay. Interesting. Okay. Holy crap. This episode. Oh my gosh. I was not prepared for the reveals, the bomb drops. Oh my God. So I gotta make sure I remember these names. Verdona, Anodyte, Anodyte, Verdona, Anodyte, Verdona, Verdona, Anodyte. Okay, time to make sure I get those pronunciations correct. I had to go back and rewatch those to make sure I got those correct. So, this episode revolved around Gwen's origins, essentially, of her powers. And we got introduced to Grandma Verdona, that is an Anodyte, that is an alien, and that's how Gwen has her powers. Explosion. Wow. Because that opening sequence where they're at the water, you know, area, the lake or whatever, and we see Brainstorm, and Kevin and Ben are going back and forth, and Brainstorm's just, his language is all over the place. Gwen's upset. But then she tells a story because where they were at was at a lake that was a place that Grandpa Max used to go to fish and everything. She's really upset. She's grieving. They see this person, a hooded figure, drop a flower off. And there's a tree that says Max and Verdona, right? And I kind of assumed that was Max, like Grandpa Max. But I was like, what's going on here? Like, what? Who is this? And it's Verdona who's leaving these like flowers made out of mana or magic or whatever. And while Gwen's gone, Kevin and Ben go up against her, right? And she starts to showcase some of her powers, which are exactly Gwen's powers. And she's enjoying this little chase. Of course, we see Jet Ray. We see Kevin trying to get in the mix. And then, of course, Gwen shows up. And then everything starts to unfold because, like, wait a minute. Because Gwen stops the attack on them and puts a force field. And she's like, do that again. Gladly throws like an energy thing or whatever. And then she starts like, wait a minute. Like, and then it starts all piecing together. And then she hugs Gwen. Assumes Ben and Gwen are brother and sister. I'm Verdona. She doesn't say I'm Grandma Verdona. But then that's where Ben's like, I think we just met our grandmother. Obviously not Kevin's, but like, what? And then another big bomb is we get to see Gwen's parents. And the father is voiced by freaking Superman, George Newbern. Oh my god, it's like, this is so cool. And he knew that his mom, Verdona, was listening in. He just knew. I think they didn't exactly imply, I mean, I don't know for sure, that he was an Anodite. Like, he actually has the gift as well. But he kind of sensed she was there. I thought that when Gwen revealed herself to her father in terms of her magic, or at least, you know, her abilities, because she's an alien, she's part alien, that, you know, Ben was going to show off that he has the Omnitrix and Kevin's abilities, but no, it was more about Gwen, you know, finally admitting to what was going on. And then Verdona shows up, and then this is where the episode kind of takes a turn, because I'm like, okay, we're about to get a lot of info dump, and we did. Verdona, I had a lot of time with Max. But when the kids grew up, we grew apart, and they showed like this like flashback kind of still frame of silhouetted is younger Max with some other, looks like plumbers or whatever behind him, it seemed. I gotta go back and look at that shot again. And I'm like, I want to see a Grandpa Max show where he's younger with the plumbers, and I want to see this. Ugh. But she starts giving all this information and tells Gwen, I'm an Anodite, all this kind of stuff. And then you can come with me to my home world. And I will teach you. And then the episode took another turn, which I wasn't expecting. And I honestly and truthfully, I feel like the ending was kind of odd, just the way it was handled. Because the other turn was she reveals her true body, which is essentially like this, I think it was like purple, black or whatever, but the hair was really colorful, or like the energy hair or whatever. And she starts to attack all three of them. Destroying the house. She already kind of showed, of course, that she can repair the house, which she repaired that glass that dropped when she teleported all of them down to the living room and repaired that glass that Gwen's mom dropped. But there's a fight on the front yard. No one else from the neighbors, which they're surrounded by neighbors. No one came out. Be too inconvenient, I guess, to show a bunch of people like look out the windows and calling police. What the fuck's going on? You know, we see this whole sequence goes down because she doesn't want to take no for an answer because Gwen doesn't want to go. Because she's up on the rooftop earlier talking about how she doesn't want to go. She wants to be human. And, of course, Kevin's like, I don't want you to go. I want you to stay here. And trying to be all, you know, Kevin. And then telling her grandma, I don't want to go with you. I want to be here. I want to be human. You know, I like my powers as they are. Doesn't take no for an answer. That's where the whole thing turns and reveals her true body, essentially. And then the fight ensues. And it wasn't, like, to the point where they were really hurting each other. But I felt like she really was going to be forceful and take Gwen, which kind of brought me some flashbacks from my personal life in terms of, anyways, not getting all that. But forcing a family member to do something you don't want to do in terms of going somewhere, that's where it flashed back for me. I'm like, oh my God, I've dealt with that with family members of mine, forced me to do stuff, go places I don't want to go. And so I was like, okay, like, I don't know how they're going to end this episode because she's being an ass now. Verdona, Grandma's being an ass. She's being an ass. She's not listening to Gwen's, like, I understand you don't have a relationship with your granddaughter, but you should, like, be approaching this differently because I get it. She's just like you. She's part alien. I understand that you have this bonding connection because you see that she has the same powers as you, all that kind of stuff. But at the same time, Gwen is choosing to be the human side of herself. And plus, over time, she's learned some shit. Because going from Ben 10 to now Alien Force, she definitely has learned more. So it's not impossible to assume that without her going with you to back to your home world, where you want to basically strip away her body to where she becomes just like you, and so you can teach her all this stuff, like, listen to her wishes. And that's where the episode kind of ended in a weird way. It's like, okay, there was like, fine, bye Grandma, you know, like, I don't know, like, she repaired everything, the house is fine now, all that, and I just kind of wish they would have found a different way to kind of end the episode, because it felt too cliche is the right word, but it just felt kind of odd. And that's the only thing I have to say negative about the episode, is that it just felt really strange how we go from this fight that wasn't, like, brutal and aggressive, like, with a real villain, but she kind of turned, in a sense. And I'm like, I don't know how they're going to end this episode. And they end in a way to where, okay, everything's fine now. Yeah, you know. Okay. I mean, she had a reminder, like, look, you miss Max, because she made a point earlier. Verdona's like, I came back because I heard about Max's passing. Once again, they're doubling down that Max is dead. Dead. I don't believe it. But anyways, that's why she showed back up again. She remembers the old times, misses him, and that kind of turned the point. Because even though she was like, you know, humans and everything, because several points, Verdona's like throughout the episode making points about how humans are this and this, you know, maybe so much time has passed because of human time, but, you know, it's different for us. But she had to be reminded that, look, you had a good time with Max. You fell in love. Like, she made a point, like, I fell in love with Max. Like, this was a big moment for you. Like, oh, I was a kid back then. I was different. This is different. Like, I understand. But I thought it was interesting that she said these things and then kind of forgot, because I think she was just so obsessed with the fact that a granddaughter, this kid who is connected to me genetically has, I think she's called the spark or something, like, basically had, because we're related in that sense that we both have the alien DNA. And I think she was obsessed with that. So she was just trying to, like, Gwen, come with me. Come back home. I want to teach you everything. I get it. Because she said that she came back at different points as well to see if other family out from her and Max, in terms of, like, the kids, grandkids, everything, to see who had any abilities. So she kept coming back. So, and the implication is she might come back again. Don't know. But this was definitely a crazy episode. I wasn't expecting that at all. Wasn't expecting to meet Grandma. At points I had mentioned, I remember exactly, in Ben 10, I made a couple of references. I'm not sure what episodes I talked about it, but I said, are we ever going to see the grandma? Are we ever going to talk about grandma? Because the only person we talked about was Xylene. That's the only character Max ever talked about. Of course, we saw her in season 3, but that's the only character we ever talked about in terms of a relation. Now, actually, no. They mentioned grandma, didn't they? Yeah. Then they mentioned that grandma died in Ben 10. So maybe they thought that she was dead. Maybe Max told them. I have to think about this. I don't know. But I was quite surprised by the reveal and everything. And Gwen's part alien. I'm forgetting the pronunciation of the name now, but I'll try to make sure to remember for future reference. But she literally is part alien, and that's where she gets her magic abilities. And Kevin mentioned this. I think it was episode 2 or no, it was 3, because it was a two-part of Ben 10 Returns Part 1 and 2. But he mentioned, referenced that there's part aliens out there. So they were kind of setting this up. They were kind of implying this might happen. I wasn't expecting it for Gwen, but I think it's interesting that Gwen's part alien. Because Ben technically is not part alien, technically, because he has the Omnitrix that can turn him into aliens. We saw Jet Ray, of course, and Spider Monkey in the episode. But, like, Ben technically is not he's not part alien. He has the Omnitrix that will turn him into aliens. Gwen's part alien, and Kevin, I'm not sure what the hell Kevin is. No idea. Is he part alien? I don't think so. But, yeah. So, crazy episode. Crazy reveals. Bomb drops. It was great to see a lot of the cool things it did in this episode. And, yeah. My whole perception of Gwen has changed to know that she has been part alien. It's crazy. But, hey. We got to hear more about some Mac stuff and meeting Grandma. Meeting Gwen's parents. Big thing. Big thing. Last thing. The little point about Gwen's dad was like, you her boyfriend? No. Well, not real. They're not dating, but I mean, you know. So what you guys think of the episode? I'm curious to know your thoughts. Whatever thoughts you have, please let me know in the comments below. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I will talk to you guys soon. Peace out.